Welcome to Hughenden Manor. I'm Keith Brody, and today we're going to take you behind the scenes looking at our beekeeping. Favourite element about beekeeping? I would expect most people to say honey, but I don't actually like honey all that much. Beekeeping is so interesting ecologically. It's so interesting as a craft. There's lots to know, there's lots of science. It's more and more interesting every year. We do need to have a thriving population of insects. If we lose the insects, we lose the ecology, because they're the source of food for many of the food chain, and the bees are a very important part of that. Bees have been around for millions of years, but we have to look after them. Loss of habitat, disease, insecticides, there's a whole range of dangers. So my hope is that we'll reverse many of the trends and get back to a healthy ecology. We are National Trust volunteers. We've been here for over 10 years and we've now got 5 live hives and the season is just beginning. The queen starts in February. The colony then is about 10,000 bees. It will build up to about 50,000 to 60,000 by the end of July. And it's important to monitor the behaviour of the bees. We can do it remotely, but we also do it by examining the hives. We remove all the winter protections and we look inside to see, is the queen laying? Is the queen there? We check that they've got enough food, they've got enough stores, which is pollen and nectar, which becomes honey. And we also are interested that they're healthy. So we examine them to see if there are any diseases or pests present. And we need to do that on a regular basis to make certain that they're okay. I mean, here we are, the bees are coming in and out. We're just in early April now, and they're collecting nectar from the early flowers, and they're collecting pollen. That's an indication that the queen is laying and there's baby bees in there, because that pollen will be feeding the baby bees. It's a feel-good factor, because we've done lots of work, we've done lots of preparation, and to see it working is really great. We only collect our honey once, usually in August, and we will do it then so that the bees have got enough time to collect more stores for the winter. The estate has got a whole range of flowering plants. We've got the parkland, which has wildflowers, including things like dandelions. We've got flowering trees, we've got the orchard and the walled garden, which have got lots of top fruit, and we're surrounded by fields. So it's tremendous around here. Domestic gardens are absolutely marvellous for pollen and for nectar. If you want to attract bees and other pollinating insects, you want simple flowers. Some insects have got short tongues, so they want flat flowers. Some have got long tongues, so they want tubular flowers. They're active from February through until November, so you want a range of plants that are flowering. We will start with snowdrops and crocus, and towards the end, in October, November time, have some ivy growing up a wall, because ivy is a very important late pollinator. Don't forget that trees are flowering plants as well, but you might want shrubs. You might want the orange buddleia, that's a break pollinator, goldenrod, things that come up every year, but you also want your nice simple bedding plants that they can get. So a wider variety as possible, as long a season as possible, and different varieties. I care about the bees because they're a symbol, they're an example of a healthy ecology. And I'm a grandfather. And I want my grandkids to grow up in at least as good an environment as I grew up in, hopefully a better one. So thanks to your support, we can continue to look after places like this wonderful site at Hughenden and looking after the environment, which is incredibly important.